everyone. It's a great day. My name is Miss Karen, and I just ran a 5K race this morning. I didn't win, but I also didn't give up. I made it all the way to the finish line, so it's time to celebrate! Woo! Yay! Ah! Oh man, I've been training all month long for this race, so it has taken a lot of commitment. Commitment is making a plan and putting it into practice. I made a plan and I practiced a lot. All that running. And strength training. Even training my brain. For a month, it's been like training is my life. I thought about this race constantly. When I decided what to eat, when I chose how to spend my time, from morning until night, I kept my mind on the race. That's what you've got to do when you truly commit to something. You've got to live like it's important to you. You have to have real commitment. Today's Bible story is about a woman who lived her whole life with commitment. And Jesus thought that what she did was pretty epic. I can't wait for you to hear this story. Let's go check it out.
The Bible. It's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how He created us and loves us so much that He made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Mark, chapter 12, verses 41 through 44.
When Jesus rode into Jerusalem on a donkey the week before Passover, the crowds were excited.
Hosanna! Hosanna! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna!
In the name of the Lord!
But the religious leaders were not.
He's turning the world upside down.
We'll have to fix that, won't we?
All week, the religious leaders sent men to try trapping Jesus with trick questions.
Teacher, is it right to pay taxes to Caesar?
Every time, Jesus gave a wise answer that caught them off guard.
Give back to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and give back to God what belongs to God.
Jesus knew the religious leaders were so puffed up with pride, they didn't want people to listen to anyone else. Jesus even warned the crowds about them.
Watch out for the teachers of the law. They love to have the most important seats. They take over the houses of widows. They say long prayers to show off.
One afternoon, Jesus and his disciples visited the temple. They sat down to rest for a moment across from the box where people came to put money they offered to God. Perhaps the disciples, mostly poor fishermen themselves, were impressed by the rich men giving gifts.
Check out his robes.
I think they actually might be silk.
Jesus watched the rich men dropping handfuls of gold coins into the box. He knew that, like the religious leaders, they were proud to show how important they were.
Check this out, world. Money, money, money. Always sunny in a rich man's world.
Even though these wealthy men were giving impressive amounts of money, Jesus knew they had so much, this was easy for them. Simply a drop in the bucket.
Huh. She looks a little out of place.
The next person in line clearly wasn't wealthy. In fact, her patched robe showed she didn't have an extra cent to spare.
A widow, probably.
At that time, if a woman's husband died, she had no way to earn money and often had to live on next to nothing.
2 pennies?
How's that gonna help anyone?
Jesus was watching the woman too, but he saw something different, something more.
Come over here, all of you,
the disciples gathered around Jesus.
What I'm about to tell you is true. That poor widow has put more into the offering box than all the others.
Jesus' friends tried to sort it out.
Excuse me, pennies versus gold?
You couldn't buy an order of fish nuggets with that.
Jesus knew what his disciples were thinking.
The others all gave a lot because they are rich, but she gave even though she is poor. She put in everything she had. That was all she had to live on.
Oh.
When you put it like that.
The rich men, like the religious leaders, were concerned with what things looked like on the outside. They didn't want to give in a big way that might force them to change on the inside. But the poor woman, who had almost nothing, chose to give everything. And Jesus saw her heart and knew that her pennies were worth far more than the rich men's gold.
Nobody else thought a poor woman giving two small coins was a big deal, but Jesus saw the truth. Other people gave because they were rich. This woman, she gave everything she had because she was putting her trust in God. She was living for Him instead of worrying about herself. Jesus was so impressed that He wanted His disciples to understand what the widow had done. He told them that not only did she do something good, but she actually gave more than the wealthy people. And that is something to celebrate. Yay! The widow was fully trusting God to provide for her needs. She was loving God with her whole life. That's what we can do too. We can choose to trust God and live fully for Him. In fact, that's something that we can do every day. It's an important part of our training plan. Practice living for God. We should be training to live for God. That is something that will help us forever. That's what our Bible verse tells us. It says, training the body has some value, but being godly has value in every way. It promises to help for the life you are now living and the life to come. 1 Timothy 4:8. Let's pray and ask God to help us practice living for Him. God, you are so good. You can see what's inside of our hearts. Help us learn to live each day for you. Help us be people who love you and trust you with everything in our lives. Help us love you this week by loving the people around us. It's so good to know that whatever we do to love you, it's a big deal to you. We love you and we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Living for God is about more than giving money. It's about trying to include God in every part of your day. It's about asking yourself before every choice you make, does this honor God? I could copy my friend's homework or do the work myself like I'm supposed to. I'm gonna do the work. Or ask yourself, does what I'm about to do show love to others? My friend didn't get me anything for my birthday. Should I get even by not getting her anything for her birthday? Or should I forgive her? Well, I did already wrap it. She's going to love it. If you ask yourself those questions, it will help you keep your mind on God. It will help you think about how Jesus lived and loved. This probably won't become a habit overnight. That's why the one thing to remember today is this: practice living for God. The more you practice asking yourself, does this honor God? And does this show love to others? The more natural it becomes. It feels good to commit to something and stick to it. I'm glad I committed to running a 5K. I feel stronger and healthier. And between you and me, I think I'm going to start training for another one. But first, we celebrate. Every day, we can choose to put God's love into action. We can live out the love of Jesus for all the world to see. Let's sing this. Come on.
Plans for me are good. You hold my future. You're working all the time. You're the mountain mover. From sunrise to sunset till the sun comes back up again. You're by my side. mountain mover. You are faithful. You are my hope. You are my future. You are the mountain mover. You are faithful. You started a good work in me. I know that you will complete it. You will see it through. Yeah, I know that you're still working on me in everything that you.